So I don't want to freak you out. I don't want to make you guys scared by talking about this because in a way it's nothing that serious, but it still is something to be concerned about. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Bethany and I do motherhood and lifestyle videos here on my channel. And today I'm going to be talking about my 21 week pregnancy update. I know you may be a little bit confused because I know I do my pregnancy updates every 2 weeks. And so this is me doing my pregnancy update 2 weeks from my last one. And that's something that I have a little bit to talk to you guys about later on in the video. So make sure you watch through and figure out what is going on, because I feel like this pregnancy, there's been so many changes going on, and just it hasn't been like the most textbook experience for me as it was for my first. Things are just so different. But anyways, I'm going to get into how baby's doing, how I'm doing, some symptoms I'm going through, and some crazy news that I found out at my ultrasound. So baby at 21 weeks is measuring about 10 and a half inches long from head to rump, and it's the size of a pomegranate according to my pregnancy app. Baby is weighing around 12.5 ounces and is definitely creeping up on becoming heavier, closer to a pound. So that's exciting. Baby is growing in there, but baby's definitely getting bigger. So around this time, you may be feeling more of baby's movements. And as I've been experiencing, instead of it being little flutters, it's definitely more of a distinctive kick, jab kind of feeling. They're a lot stronger. They're not as fluttery as they used to be. Also, one thing that is happening around this time is that you may be discovering a type of pattern in your baby's movements if you are feeling them, and that is definitely true for me. I've been feeling baby movements a lot, and definitely in certain times of the day. So my belly is now measuring at about 33.5 inches, so it grew about 1/2 inch in the last 2 weeks, which is great. It means my belly is on schedule and everything's looking good. I'm feeling a lot more rounder. Even my husband noticed that my belly is sticking out a lot more, and you know, he's like, whoa, I think your belly really popped overnight. Sometimes I wake up and I look in the mirror and I definitely notice a difference on my belly and how it's looking. So I'm definitely excited that I'm looking a lot more rounder and looking a lot more pregnant. So if you guys haven't seen my gender reveal video, I did that about 2 weeks ago. And it's super, super exciting for us because we found out that we're having a baby boy. So exciting, so exciting. I thought it was a boy like for the longest time. At the beginning of my pregnancy, I never really had any sort of gut feeling, but as time went on, I think I felt around maybe 10 weeks, I was like, I definitely feel like this is gonna be a boy. Everything was just so different with this pregnancy and almost like the complete opposite of my daughter. I know that doesn't really mean much, but at the end of the day, I just was like, this is too different to be another girl. I can just feel it. And of course, I mean, my guess is only 50% correct, right? It could be. So we are so, so thrilled. I always imagined myself having a little boy, and I'm so excited to have that little mother-son bond. I am really, really excited about having a son. Makes me so excited. I absolutely love thinking about it. And now I finally feel like I'm able to start buying things for little boy and just kind of plan. I'm a planner. And so that's why we like to find out the gender, because I like to kind of start doing things. I know what I need to buy, like what kind of colors and stuff like that. So I'm definitely curious to see what he's gonna look like. But as we got this great profile shot of him on our ultrasound, and he looks so much like his sister Brielle. Oh my goodness, they look so similar. You can definitely tell that it's gonna be our baby for sure. So I'm just gonna go through some of the symptoms that I've been having these past 2 weeks. And let me tell you, things are getting a lot more serious. Things are getting a lot more uncomfortable as time goes on. That's just how pregnancy works. The longer you're pregnant, the more uncomfortable you become. And I'm finding with my second pregnancy, it's become a lot more uncomfortable a lot quicker than it did with my daughter. And I was talking to my midwife about this, and she said that it's just true that your body just seems like after your first pregnancy, she said it kind of just goes downhill from there. And I'm like, oh, that's kind of encouraging. But not for her to be negative. It's just kind of the truth. Your body is just has gone through something like this before, and it's just, it aches a lot more. So basically my lower back has started to hurt. I did experience this with my daughter, but not as early. I find it's because I'm bending down a lot more. I'm picking up my daughter. I'm just straining a lot more with my back. So I'm hopefully going to be starting going to the chiropractor pretty soon here. I find that going to the chiropractor helped me so much after my pregnancy with Brielle, which was absolutely amazing. It fixed my back completely, so I'll definitely be going back there to help my back out during this pregnancy. So if you didn't follow me, or if you don't follow me on Instagram, I kind of talked about why I took a break, about a week off of doing any sort of work. I just needed to take a break. I was feeling a lot of tightness in my belly, especially in my lower portion of my stomach, kind of just above my pubic bone. It was like this constant tightening feeling. It wasn't like coming in waves. It wasn't like Braxton Hicks where it tightens and then goes away. It was nothing like false labor, nothing like that. It was just a constant tightening feeling, and it was like a dull 3 on the pain scale, and it was extremely uncomfortable. I'm not someone who, you know, asks my midwife questions all the time. I don't need to contact her about every little thing, but I contacted her about this because I was kind of concerned because it was really bothering me, and I was just kind of like, I hope the baby's okay. She just said to kind of take it easy. She did schedule me to get some urine tested. That came back normal, nothing wrong. She thought it could be a bladder infection because I was feeling some back pain, but that was just from lifting things and whatnot. It's just being a part of being pregnant, I guess. Yeah, so basically I took a week off of work and just took it easy around the house, and it actually did end up going away. So I think my body just needed a break, and so did my mind. And so I needed to take that time for me and just to make sure that everything was going fine. Another thing that's been going on is my sleep patterns haven't been the greatest. I find that sleeping is now becoming uncomfortable for me, as sleeping on my side, I find, really hurts my back. It's just my back just doesn't like me this pregnancy at all. And so I am sleeping with a pillow between my legs, so that makes me more comfortable. I'd highly recommend getting a pregnancy pillow. I borrowed someone's for my last pregnancy, and it was so nice. I just haven't been able to go out and buy one myself this time, and that's okay. I'm gonna see if I can make do not having one, but if you have, you know, the ability to, I'd highly recommend it. Another great thing is that I am feeling a lot more energetic. I feel like I have a lot more energy, I have a lot more stamina when it comes to doing regular normal things, which makes me really happy because I kind of get depressed if I don't have the energy to get through the day. All right, so I really hope that this doesn't become a super duper long video, but I'm just gonna kind of be updating you guys on my midwife appointment that I had today, and then kind of some changes that I found out at my ultrasound with baby and with me. So I don't wanna freak you out. I don't wanna make you guys scared by talking about this, because in a way it's nothing that serious, but it still is something to be concerned about. We did have an ultrasound at the beginning of the month on the 9th of August, and that's when we found out that we were having a boy, which is awesome. But also they found some other things going on. So the first thing is that my due date has now changed. So I'm actually measuring a week behind schedule. So instead of me being 22 weeks today, I am actually 21 weeks today. Surprise! So my new due date is now January 3rd, which is crazy because now I'm looking at having a baby in 2019 instead of 2018, which is exciting and awesome. And who knows, maybe I'll have this baby on January 1st and I'll have two babies born on the first of a month. That would be so cool. So this actually doesn't make me feel discouraged at all. I was kind of hoping that this baby would be born in January anyway, because I really hope he's not born on Christmas Day. I would feel terrible for him because, I mean, sometimes you just don't get the attention that you would like on your birthday when it's on Christmas. So that's just my personal preference for him. But again, whenever he comes would just be fine anyway. So something that my midwife did mention to me after the ultrasound is that there is something to note about baby's kidneys. So there's something called prenatal hydronephrosis, which is kind of something not to be alarmed of. It's not something that is, you know, gonna create extreme problems for the baby. But basically what it is that within the kidneys, there are some tubes called ureters. And when they become a little bit dilated, it is kind of a bit of a concern. So babies, ureters, that sounds so, I can't say it, so bad. But basically, they were a little bit dilated. They were still in the normal range, but they were just a little bit dilated. So this happens actually in 1 in 100 pregnancies. So it's not super duper uncommon, but my midwife said like she's only experienced it about 5 times and in her entire career. But every single time that, you know, there's been this problem, which can create a blockage in the urinary tract and things like that. All of these children live normal lives. This is not something that is like, oh my gosh, his kidneys are failing, you know, things like that. It's not super duper serious, but if he does have a certain stage of it, he might need surgery, but will still live a normal life. So if you want to do more reading about this, that's just kind of like a really, really like low-key description of it. I will put a link down below to an article about it so you can read a little bit more if you're curious. But it's not something I'm super worried about. Basically, they're just going to do an ultrasound as soon as he's born to make sure everything's fine, everything's functioning normally, and that those tubes are looking normal and they're not blocked. You know, if my midwife's not too concerned about it, and I've done my research, and all the research that I've done basically says that he will live a normal life. Like there should be nothing that would block him off from having that. That doesn't make me super concerned. Obviously, it's something to be aware of. I'm just gonna be thinking that this pregnancy is normal, baby is healthy, everything is fine. Because if I don't think about it too much and I get worried about it, then that's not gonna be good for me, and ultimately that's not gonna be good for my baby if I'm under stress and anxiety. So that's kind of everything that's going on. It's not something to be super, super concerned about, something to be really kind of worrying about, but it's something that's there, and we'll just check to see if everything's okay once he's born. But other than that, there's not much that we can do except to just eat as well as I can, get enough rest, and just continue to grow this babe. Anyways, that kind of wraps up this pregnancy update, you guys. I hope you did enjoy it. I hope you found it informational and helped you on your own pregnancy journey. If you haven't subscribed, make sure you do that, and we'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!